Morena, everyone. If you are just tuning in, we are at the Ministry of Social Development office in Manurewa. About 20 people, maybe 25 now, arriving for hardship allowances. This is a staggering figure. 573,000 hardship allowances were given out in the September quarter. That's one quarter. Total cost of the hardship allowances, $167 million. That's over and above the money being paid out on benefits. Are we getting our social policy right? It's obviously going to be a big battleground for the next elections, with the Nats having their discussion document. We're going to be joined live here by Louise Upston shortly. But we're going to bring in now Marama Davidson, co-leader of the Green Party, who is joining us live from Wellington. She is not in Auckland today, but we're delighted to have you with us on the show. Tēnā koe, Marama, so good to have you with us. I want to go back to mending the safety net, which was your Green Party policy going into the election in 2017. And really the headline hope or promise in it was, and I quote, increase all core benefits by 20%. How are you going with that?
We haven't done that yet, John, and it still remains an absolute priority. People lining up outside work and income offices makes it clear people simply don't have enough, and that needs to change.
The issue is, and I don't think we understand this as a country, we are not spending the money on benefits, but we are spending it on our hardship allowances. $167 million extra in a quarter. Do you think people know that story?
I think more and more New Zealanders are realising that this is simply not good enough. More and more people are struggling, John, and so it's likely that many families, either themselves or know of people, who are simply not making ends meet every week, every day. Rather than hardship grants, people should have enough income in the first instance to live their lives with dignity.
Certainly that was the recommendation of the Welfare Expert Advisory Group, and you really strongly welcomed their report that was released in May. What do you make of the government's response to the Welfare Expert Advisory Group report and its recommendations?
We need to see all of the recommendations put in place. The Welfare Expert Advisory Group did incredible hard work, the most amazing work we have seen on welfare reform to date in this country. And they gave us a blueprint to overhaul the system so that it's one that allows people to seek support when they need it. The government, we are very clear that we need to see a time frame for the entire plan and all of the recommendations to be put in place. We haven't yet seen that.
Are you being stymied by your coalition partners?
That's a question for the coalition partners, for the other political parties. We are very clear, and we want to be clear to people, to the people lining up outside that office, John, right there this morning, that it is the Green Party who know we need to treat people with compassion. People are just trying to do their best with what they've got. And, you know, we have for far too long kept benefits at an inadequately low level. They need to be increased, and there are a whole range of other levers that governments can pull that need to happen as well.
Absolutely, but I want to come back to my question, are you being stymied by your coalition partners? And I want to ask you what you think, really. And I want to go back to all your campaigning you did. Increase core benefits by 20%, overhaul the welfare system. That phrase is a key part of your coalition agreement with Labor. Increase incomes. It's not happening. You want it to happen. Are you being held back by your coalition partners?
The phrase of overhauling the welfare system is absolutely part of our agreement with Labor. What that looks like has been up for debate, yes, John. I'm very clear that if people want to see us overhauling the safety net and particularly increasing the core benefits, we'll need to see more Green MPs come into Parliament, come into governmental power. Right now, we will keep pushing and working for that, but it's not happening. Yes, it's not happening right now.
And why isn't it happening? Why isn't a Labor-led coalition government doing this?
I still think those are definitely questions for the Labor government and for the Labor ministers responsible. For us, we are very clear that this is a priority. Increasing core benefits needs to be a priority to help people live good lives, and that's something that the Greens are very clear we need to do. We don't see that there's any reason to allow for people to keep struggling in this way.
Boy, this is going to be a battlefield, isn't it, in the next 12 months with the National Party Social Services discussion document out, and the sense from the Nats that they have a very different, almost antithetical approach to this from the Greens. So the argument is carrot, stick, sanctions, dignity. How big is the safety net? How do we get this right as a country? How do we do what's fair when the tribal divisions are already so profound?
And I know that many New Zealanders, that most New Zealanders care about supporting people, and that's what we're going to lean into. That's the debate that we need to be having, is how do we support people better? How do we stop...
I'm so sorry to interrupt, but Louise Upston is going to join us later in the program. She's going to come out here, and I'm delighted she's joining us. Carmel Cipollone declined our invitation to appear since she wasn't available. Louise Upston's going to come out and say, we need to incentivise these people to get work, and we need potentially to be tougher with them, and we need to restore sanctions. What is your response to that?
What we know is people are already trying their best, John. They're trying to do their best. I've stood in those lines outside those offices. You're in my community. I've talked to those people. You're talking about mums and children who are just trying to do their best, elderly people, people who are sick, people who are on low incomes and still need some income support to complement. We're talking about people who actually are trying their best, and the Greens will not stand for the country and politicians dehumanising those people even further.
Are we getting this right?
Not yet. Not yet, John. We have made some important starts and some important steps, like the Welfare Expert Advisory Group being pulled together. We need to continue to prioritise raising core benefits. We need to make sure housing, public affordable housing, is available. We need to make sure that people are earning a living wage at the very least. There's a whole lot more to do, and we need to do it faster, but we have made some important first steps.
Marama Davidson, Green Party co-leader, joining us live from Wellington. Thank you so much for your time this morning.